Hello everyone, this is Sharada and you are watching Duggani Sisters. Today I will be continuing with exercise 1.2 in integers. So before starting it, if you are watching my channel for the first time, do subscribe and click on bell icon to get the notification of my latest video. So let me start. So this is exercise 2, fourth problem. The temperature at 12 noon was 10 degrees centigrade above zero. If it decreases at the rate of 2 degrees centigrade per hour until midnight, at what time would the temperature be 8 degrees centigrade below 0? What would be the temperature at midnight? So here you have to see what is given and what you have to find out. So the temperature at 12 noon was 10 degrees centigrade below above 0. So let me... It is at 12 noon, the temperature was 10 degrees centigrade above 0. So above 0 is nothing but it's a positive value, 10 degrees centigrade. If it decreases at the rate of 2 degrees centigrade per hour, so every hour 2 degrees centigrade, the value per hour it is decreasing. So every hour it becomes minus 2 until midnight. So this will continue up to midnight. At what time would the temperature be 8 degrees centigrade below 0? So below 0 is minus 8 degrees. So they are asking at what time the temperature will be minus 8 degrees centigrade. So what would be the temperature at midnight? So here we should find out at what time the temperature. So here we should find out the time at what time it becomes minus 8 degrees centigrade. And here at midnight, what is the temperature you have to find out? So these two we have to find out in this question. So here we have to find out midnight what is the temperature and at what time the temperature will be minus 8 degrees. So here initial, now the time is, the temperature is 10 degrees centigrade. So this is at 12 noon. So next at 1 o'clock, so every hour the temperature is going to reduced by minus 2. So at 1 o'clock it will be minus 10 minus 2, that is 8 degrees centigrade. In the same way, 2 o'clock it will be 8 minus 2, that is 6 degrees centigrade. At 3 o'clock it is 6 minus 2, that is 4 degrees centigrade. Instead of doing in this way, we can do the same as 10 degrees centigrade plus 12 into minus 2 degrees centigrade. So this is nothing but 10 plus 12, 2 is 24, but here you have a minus sign. So I'm writing minus sign. So that is nothing but 10 plus into minus is minus 24. So here plus 10 minus 24 is nothing but minus 14. So at midnight the temperature is minus 14 degrees centigrade. Now the first part is completed and now we should find out what is the time at which the temperature is minus 8 degrees centigrade. So here, next is 4. So 4 minus 2 is 2 degrees centigrade. Now this is all positive, above 0. Now we should find out minus 8 degrees. So this is nothing but again at 5 o'clock the time is 2 minus 2, that is 0 degrees centigrade. And next 0 minus 2 is minus 2 degrees centigrade. 2 minus 2 minus 2 is minus 4 degrees centigrade. Minus 4 minus 2 is minus 6 degrees centigrade. Minus 6 minus 2 is minus 8 degrees centigrade. So here it is at 6 o'clock it is minus 2 degrees. At 7 o'clock minus 4 degrees. At 8 o'clock, it is minus 6 degrees, and at 9 o'clock, it is minus 8 degrees. So, at what time the temperature is minus 7 is? At 9 o'clock, the time is also calculated. So, this is all calculation part. So, how to calculate, I have explained. Now, this can be said as, now second part. Now the temperature that at noon was 10 degrees centigrade, and we don't know what at how many times we have to, so I'm taking it as x minus 2, so that is equal to minus degrees. So this is nothing but 10 degrees centigrade plus minus 2x is equal to minus 8 degrees centigrade. Minus 2x is equal to minus 8 plus minus 8 degrees centigrade minus 10 degrees. So this is nothing but minus 2x is equal to minus 18. X is equal to minus 18 by minus 2. So minus minus gets cancelled. It is 9. So at 9 p.m. the temperature is minus 8 degrees centigrade. So in this way also you can find out. This is trial and error method I have done. This is the process I have done to find out the temperature. At 9 o'clock it is minus 8 degrees centigrade. Here the next one is, a green grocer earns a profit of 7 rupees per kg of tomato and got loss of 4 rupees per kg of brinjal by selling. On Monday, he gets neither profit nor loss. If he sold 68 kg of tomato, how many kgs of brinjal did he sell? Now, the given part is 7 rupees he earns per kg of tomatoes. On selling tomatoes, he gets 7 rupees gain, and 4 rupees per kg on selling brinjal. Okay, so on selling tomatoes he is going to earn 7 rupees, on selling brinjals he is going to sell 4 rupees. Now the question is, on Monday he gets neither profit nor loss. So Monday his sale of tomatoes and brinjals is not known, but he did not get the profit or loss. So what is answer? If he sold 68 kgs of tomato, how many kgs of brinjal? So 68 kgs of tomatoes is given. So 68 kg of tomato. So on selling tomato, he gets 7 rupees profit. So into 7 should be equal to, now because he said he did not get profit or loss, it was same. So when it will be same? When the profit and loss is this, tomatoes profit and brinjal's profit, if it is same, then it will, then he will not get profit or loss. So x into rupees 4. So this rupees, so I should find out how many kgs of brinjal he sold. So this is nothing but x is equal to 68 into 7 by, so this is unknown quantity and is kept here itself, and this sent to the other side, so it is divided 4 ones 4 ones 4 sevens, so it is nothing but 119. So the unknown quantity is brinjal, so he sold 119 kgs of brinjal by taking profit of 4 rupees, and he has sold 68 kgs of tomatoes with profit of 7. So this time if you want you can check it out. So this is 68 into 7 is, yes, it is 6476, and in the same way 119 kg of brinjal with a profit of 4 rupees, so it is 674. So here the both the quantities are same, that means he did not get profit nor loss. So therefore, how many kgs he sold brinjal? He sold 119 kgs of brinjal. So this is next question. In a test, plus 3 marks is allotted for the correct answer and minus 1 mark for the incorrect answer. So Sona attempted all the questions, but she scored plus 20 marks, though she got 10 correct answers. How many incorrect answers she attempted? How many questions were given in the test? So here you have to find out how many incorrect answers she has attempted and how many total questionnaire has how many questions. So before that, let me give the gist of it. So she has written 10 correct. So 10 into 3 marks is allotted for the correct answer. So into 3 minus of. So how many she has written incorrect, we don't know. So I'm assuming it as x is equal to, by attempting 10 correct answers and subtracting the wrong answers, she scored 20 marks. Now we should find out how many incorrect answers she has written. So x I'm taking as number of incorrect. So now here this unknown value is kept here and send the known value is sent to the other side. So 10 threes is 30 minus x is equal to 20. So this known value I'm sending to other side, it here it is plus, when goes to other side becomes minus. So minus x as it is equal to 20 minus 30. So minus x is equal to 10 minus 30, 20 minus 30 is 10, and because you have a bigger number minus sign, you get minus sign. So here minus minus gets cancelled, x is equal to 10. So she has answered, Sona has answered 10 incorrect answers. Yes. So now the second question is, how many questions were given in the test. Now here already in the question it is given that 10 she has attempted correctly, and we have solved and found out that she has written 10 incorrect. So total number of questions in test is equal to 10 correct plus 10 incorrect, that is 20 questions. Yes. So here incorrect answers, she has attempted 10 incorrect answers and total questions in the questionnaire was 20 questions. So let me continue with the next one. Here the next question is, write 5 pairs of integers where a comma b such that a divided by b is minus 4. So here we have to take the 5 pairs of numbers where when I divide, I'll get the quotient as minus 4. So first number I'll assume as, now you can remember, you can take like this, 28 divided by 7 is 4, 36 divided by 9 is 4. So you can take the multiples of 4 to make it easy. Yes, so I'll, multiples of 4 are 4, 8, 12, 16, 20, 24, 32, 36. Sorry, here 28, 32, 36. Now here, when I divide a number with 4, I should get the quotient as minus 4. So only from here I can take this. So I'm going to take from 12. So here the first combination I'm taking is 12 and 3, but here in the quotient we have a negative sign, so either any one of the numbers should have a minus sign. So I'm taking minus 12 comma 3. So let me show, minus 12 divided by 3, so this can be written as minus 12 by 3, 3 ones, 3 fours, so quotient is minus 4. So the second combination is 16 comma 4. It can be minus for the 16 or 4. So I'll take for minus 4. 16 divided by minus 4. So this is nothing but 16 by minus 4, 4 ones, 4 fours. So here it is 4 by minus 1. So this can be written as minus 4. So other three integer pairs can be 20, minus 20 comma 5, minus 24 comma 6, 28 comma minus 7. So these three combination, when you divide, you are going to get the quotient minus 4. It can be this, or you can take some other numbers. So these are the five pairs of integers where the quotient is minus 4. Hope you have understood. If you have understood, please like, share and subscribe to my channel. Thank you for watching.